गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट TDP सब्जेक्ट एंड द टॉपिक नेम इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम विच इज योर चैप्टर नंबर 4। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन। द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज जनरेटेड एट द पावर स्टेशंस। The electrical energy is demanded by the consumers as it is the necessary to supply the power to the consumers. But the power stations are located far away from the town or cities. Hence, the large network is used between the consumers and power station is classified into two groups. First one is transmission systems, second one is the distribution systems. In this subject, generation and transmission, we have discussed about the transmission systems. Now we discuss about the classification of distribution systems. The distribution system can be classified as a below. First one, based on nature of current. There are the two types of distribution system based on nature of current. First one is the AC distribution system. AC distribution system is again divided into two parts. First one is the primary distribution systems and second one is the secondary distribution systems. And second one is the DC distribution systems. Now based on type of construction. There are the two types of distribution system based on type of construction. First one is the overhead distribution systems and second one is the underground distribution systems. And third number, based on the scheme of connections. There are the three types of distribution system based on the scheme of connection. First one is the radial distribution systems, second one is the ringman distribution systems, and third one is the interconnected grid distribution systems. Now we discuss about the one by one distribution systems in detail. First one is the AC distribution systems. There are the two types of AC distribution systems. First one is the primary distributions. The power transmitted through the secondary transmission is collected at various substations. At these substations, the voltage is reduced to the 11 kV with the help of the step-down transformer. Then this power is distributed to the pole-mounted substation with the help of the feeder. Sometimes the 11 kV supply is directly to the consumer premises. This type of consumer known as the HT consumers. The primary distribution use the three-phase, three-wire overhead system or underground systems. This type of distribution used for the primary distributions. The schematic diagram of the three-phase, three-wire AC distribution system is shown below figure. Now we discuss about the second part, is the secondary distribution systems. The power distributed through the primary distribution is collected at various pole mounted substations. At these substations, the voltage is reduced to the 400 volt with the help of the step down transformer. Then this power is distributed to the consumer with the help of distributors. This type of consumer are known as the LT consumers. The secondary distribution uses the three-phase, four-wire overhead system or underground system. The fourth wire in this system is neutral. This type of system is generally used for the secondary distribution purpose. The schematic diagram of the three-phase, four-wire AC distribution system is shown below figure. Now we discuss about the difference between the primary distribution and secondary distribution system in below table. The difference is different types of use, like a different topics. First one is the distribution's voltage. So primary distribution is 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV or 11 kV. While secondary distribution is 400 volt for a three phase and 230 watt for a single phase. Now second topic is the source of power. So primary distribution, the distribution substations, and secondary distribution, the pole mounted substation I use. Third topic is medium for transfer power. In primary distribution, the power transferred by a feeder, and secondary distribution, the power transferred by distributor. Fourth topic is the tapping. In primary distribution, no tapping are taken. While the secondary distribution, the tapping are taken. Fifth topic is use. Primary distribution generally used for HT consumers, while secondary distribution used for the LT consumers. Now we discuss about generation, transmission and distribution voltages. The commonly used generation, transmission and distribution voltages are given as a below table. Now we discuss about particular topics and the voltage level for this. So first is generation. Generation is a voltage level is generally for 6.6 kV, 11 kV, 22 kV and 33 kV. Second one is the primary transmission. The primary transmission voltage level is generally 66 kV, 132 kV, 220 kV and 400 kV. Third one is the secondary transmission. The secondary transmission voltage level is generally 11 kV, 22 kV, 33 kV and 66 kV. Fourth one is the primary distribution. The primary distribution voltage level is 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV and 11 kV. And fifth one is the secondary distribution. The secondary distribution voltage level is 230 volt for a single phase and 400 volt for a three phase. Now we discuss about the components of distribution systems. The various components of the distribution system are described below the showing figure. In figure we show you that some are substations, some are HT consumers, some are LT consumers, some have a feeder, some have a pole mounted substation, some have a serviceman, some have a distributors. Now one by one we discuss in detail. Now we discuss about the first one is a feeder. The power transmitted through the secondary transmission is collected at various substations. At this substation, the voltage is reduced to the 11 kV with the help of the step down transformer. Then this power is distributed to the pole mounted substation. The conductor which are used for the transfer the power from the substation to the pole mounted substation are known as the feeders. It means the feeders are one type of a conductors. No tappings are taken from the feeders. Thus the feeder current always remain constant. The feeders are also used to supply the power to the HT consumers. Now we discuss about the second one is the distributors. The power distributed from the substation through the feeder is collected at the various pole mounted substations. At this substations, the voltage is reduced to 400 volt with the help of the step down transformer. The power is distributed to the consumers. The conductor which are used to transfer the power from the pole mounted substation to the consumer are known as the distributors. It means the distributors are also one type of the conductors. The tappings are taken from the various distributors to the supply the power to the consumers. Thus the current in the different sections of the distributors are not a constant. Now we discuss about the third one. Third one is the servicemen. The servicemen are the small cables. The main function of the serviceman is to the transfer the power from the distribution to the consumer premises. Now we discuss about the different connection schemes of distribution systems. There are the three types of connection schemes of distribution system. First one is a radial distribution system. The distribution system in which the distributor is connected with the substation at one end only with the help of feeder is known as the radial distribution system, which is shown below figure. Here we show in the figure one is the feeder and other is the distributors, and distributors are connected with servicemen. The distributor is connected only at one end to the substation through the feeder at a point P. In this system, if the fault occurs on the feeder or distributor, then all the consumers connected to the distributor will get affected. It means it caused the interruption of the supply. Also, the consumer at the end at a point Q will get the less voltage due to the large voltage drop in the distributor. Now we discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of radial distribution system. First one, we discuss about the advantage of radial distribution systems. This method is very simple as it is fed at only one end. The initial cost of this method is very low. This method is used when the distribution is at a low voltage. This method can be preferred when the substation is located at the center of the load. Now we discuss about the disadvantage of radial distribution systems. The distributor section near the substation gets heavily loaded. This method is not reliable. The consumer at the far end of the distributor gets the low voltage due to the large voltage drop. Now we discuss about the second connection scheme, whose name is the ringman system. The distribution system in which the feeder covers the whole area of the supply in the ring fashion is known as the ringman systems. It is also called the parallel or closed loop system, which is shown below figure, and the feeder divided into five sections like AB, BC, CD, DE and EA, which is shown below figure. The closed loop ring known as a feeder. The distributors are connected at A, B, C, D and E. Each distributor is supplied by two feeders. Hence, if the fault occurs on any part of one feeder, then the consumer still gets the continuous power from the another feeder. In this method of feeding, the feeder can be fed at one or more feeding points. But if it is required to supply large area using the ringman system, then the large voltage drop may be occur across the various sections of the feeder. And to reduce this voltage drop, the far points of the ring distributor are joined together by conductor. This conductor is known as the interconnector. Now we discuss about the advantages of ringman distribution systems. The continuity of the supply can be maintained even through the fault occurs or on any point of the feeder. This method is more reliable. This is because if the fault occurs on any one distributor, then the other consumer gets the continuous power as they are connected on the other distributors. This method requires the less copper as compared to the radial distribution systems. Now we discuss about the third one, whose name is interconnected grid type distribution systems. This type of distribution system is used where the reliability is very important factor. It means it is used to the primary distributions and some secondary distribution systems. This type of distribution system is known as a grid, which is shown below figure. The point P and Q are two main transmission substations, while the A, B, C, D and E are the distribution substations. The substation A, B, C and D are interconnected. It means the fault occurs on any part of the system does not interrupt the continuity of supplies. Now we discuss about the advantages of the interconnected ring distributor systems. First one is it requires the small size of the substation as compared to the radial systems. Second one is the reliability is higher compared to the other distributor systems. थर्ड वन इज द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज मोर, फोर्थ वन इज द वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन इज वेरी गुड कंपेयर टू द रेडियल सिस्टम, फिफ्थ वन इज द रिजर्व कैपेसिटी कैन बी रिड्यूस, एंड लास्ट इज द लोड फैक्टर एंड डाइवर्सिटी फैक्टर कैन बी इम्प्रूव बाय द इंटरकनेक्टेड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम्स। Now we discuss about the requirements of good distribution systems. The first one is the economical. It means the distribution system should be very economical. Second one is the variation in the voltage. It means the voltage at the consumer's premises should be not vary more than the prescribed limits. As per the Indian electricity rules, the voltage variation should not be exceed 5% of its rated voltage. Third one is the continuity of supply. It means the distribution system should be supply the power continuously without any interruptions. Fourth one is the good appearance. It means the layout of the distribution system should not affect the local appearance. Fifth one is the safe or say safety. It means the distribution line should not be leaked from the safety point of view. Sixth one is the not overloaded. It means the distribution line should not be overloaded. And the last one is the efficiency. The efficiency of the distribution line should be high as possible. Now we discuss about the difference between AC distribution calculation and DC distribution calculation as a below table. Now first topic is the voltage drop. AC distribution calculation, the voltage drop due to the resistance, inductance and capacitance, while DC distribution calculation, it is due to the resistance only. Now second topic is addition and subtraction of voltage and current. In AC distribution calculation system, it is a vectorly. It means it also requires the directions. While DC distribution system, it is done directly arithmetically. Now third topic is the power factor. In AC distribution calculation, the power factor present and should be taken into the account. While DC distribution calculation, the power factor is absent. Thank you. After this video, the chapter number 4 or unit number 4 is completed. Thank you once again.